Hello everyone. The other timers in the time instruction group are the Re-triggerable One-Shot Timer On, the Software Pulse Width Modulation, and Wait. Let's start with the Re-triggerable One-Shot Timer On, ROTON. First, drag a contact into the room and variable S.1 into the contact. Then, drag a ROTON into the room. Assign variable T.1 to it and a preset value of 10. Observe that the ROTON has similar parameters as the previous timers, except for E, N, and D, N status. When simulated, the ROTON ACC value will start decreasing from the preset value of 10 when S.1 is true. At the same time, TT status will become true. If S.1 is made false, and then true again, TT will remain true, and ACC will start decreasing from the preset value again. TT will become false when ACC is 0. Now, insert a rung below. Drag in a contact and a coil. Drag to the contact, variable T.1.TT, and to the coil, arrow.1. Using the same circuit connections from previous videos, upload the codes to the PLC, ensuring that Nano V5 is selected from the settings menu. Repeatedly press the push button switch. Observe that the indicator lamp comes on and remains on as long as the switch is being pressed. If you stop pressing the switch, the lamp will go off after 10 seconds. The ROTON can be used to set off an alarm if a part of a machine that is required to always be in motion fails. Let us now consider the Software Pulse Width Modulation, SPWM. Delete the ROTON and drag SPWM into its place. Observe that the available status bits are EN and ST. The instruction generates a series of square waves, whose duration, on and off time, can be set on the instruction. When the wrong condition is true, ST will be true for the duration of the on value multiplied by the time base. Then it will become false for the duration of the off value. This continues until the wrong condition becomes false. Double-click on the time base and change it to 10 milliseconds. Set both the on and off values as 50. Right-click on T.1.TT variable on this contact and navigate to P.1 and then ST to change the variable type to that of the SPWM. Then go to simulation mode and enable contact S.1. Observe that ST status repeatedly goes from true to false when the wrong condition is true, thus generating a blinking effect on arrow.1, which can also be seen on the indicator lamp when uploaded into the PLC. Finally, the wait instruction can be used to achieve small delays between 1 to 1000 milliseconds. That is about all for the timers. Next is the counters. Thanks for watching. Please hit the like button and drop a comment if you enjoyed this video. Don't leave without subscribing to this channel if you have not. Bye for now.